Hi there.
This video is about Next Style in InDesign. Next Style applies another defined style to the next paragraph when you type a return at the end of a paragraph. A paragraph return signifies the end of one style and the beginning of the new one. I have this information already typed in, and if you look closely, you'll find that there are four headings repeated several times. We have item number, item name, item price, and item description. One important aspect of Next Style is that it only works when there is a kind of repetitiveness. If one of my items is occupying one line and the other one is occupying two, then this won't work, because the next command is going to consider that to be another paragraph, hence the styling will fall apart. So this really has to be a defined list of regular paragraph breaks. Alright, make sure the text box is not selected. Click the small plus button at the bottom of the paragraph styles panel to create a new paragraph style. Double-click and rename it item number, prefixing it with 1 as the serial number. I don't want to base it on anything, so let it stay based on no paragraph style. Move on to basic character formats tab. Change the fonts to Museo Sans and font style to 500. Move on to character color tab and change the color of the text should you want. I am going to keep it black for this one, so hit OK. Similarly, let's create another paragraph style and rename it item name, prefixing it with 2 as the serial number. Adding serial numbers is optional, but it really helps in quick sequencing. I don't want to base it on anything, so let's change that here. Let's move on to basic character formats tab and change the font style to 700. The previous settings of the font was already there, so I didn't have to change it. Let's also check the underline box and then move on to character color tab and change the color to pink and hit OK. Same way, add a third paragraph style and rename it item price, prefixing it with 3 as the serial number. Update the based on option to no paragraph style and then move on to basic character formats. Update the font style to 900 and then move on to character color tab and change the color back to black and hit OK. Now add the last paragraph style and rename it item description with a prefix of 4 as the serial number. Update the based on option to no paragraph style and then move on to basic character formats tab and change the font style to 300 italics and uncheck the underline box and then move on to character color tab to choose your color should you want to. I'm going to stick to black for this one and hit OK. Now all the paragraph styles are done. All we need to do is connect them. So double-click the first one and click the next style drop-down. And since this is the paragraph style of the first item, we're going to select the second one from the list and hit OK. Similarly, double-click the second one this time and from the next style drop-down list, select the third item and hit OK. Now double-click the third item and from the next style list, select the fourth one and hit OK. Lastly, double-click the fourth one and from the next style list, select the first one. We select the first one to create a loop because there are only 4 paragraph styles. The last one needs to be tagged to the first one and then hit OK. Now make sure none of your paragraph styles are selected. Click the text box once to select it and then take your cursor to the first paragraph style, which is item number, and then right click and select apply item number, then next style option. The moment it's clicked, you'll find all the paragraph styles are perfectly assigned to their respective items. Not just that, if you click the text box and start typing in a fifth item in the same order, it should follow the same style seamlessly. Mostly it's used to create catalogs or databases where one can find repetitive fields and information, so do make good use of it. Alright guys, that concludes our session. Hope you've enjoyed it, so I'm going to see you in the next one. Goodbye.